बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम टू इंटरनेशनल इस्लामिक यूनिवर्सिटी इस्लामाबाद स्कूल साहिवाल कैंपस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स। दिस इज़ द लेक्चर ऑफ ग्रेड 5 इंग्लिश यूनिट नंबर 2 डायलॉग। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन द यूनिट नंबर 2 फ्रॉम आवर स्टूडेंट्स बुक। वी ऑलरेडी हैव कवर्ड द यूनिट नंबर 1 फ्रॉम आवर स्टूडेंट्स बुक एंड आवर वर्क बुक। When we started the unit number 1, we covered the reading and explanation from the lesson. Then we moved towards the exercise, where the first section of exercise was question answers. I have given you the solution of those exercises, those questions, and you have written all the solutions in your classwork notebook and your student's book. Then we moved further towards other exercises, where we have done the language portion, the grammatical part, and the word study and writing portions from our students' book and workbook also. All the exercises have done, and some of the exercises from your students' book and your workbook were given you as your homework. I hope you all have done your all of the homeworks from your unit number 1, and today we are going to begin the unit number 2. This is the lecture number 1 from your unit number 2. Dear students, as this is the first lecture of our unit number 2, so we will begin with the reading of the lesson. Before we begin with the reading, just make sure that you have your English students book, your English classwork notebook, your workbook, and your complete stationery that you need with you. Listen to the lecture attentively and write down all the stuff asked by teacher in your classwork notebook, your student's book, or your workbook, wherever teacher asks you. If you find anything difficult, anything that you don't understand in this lesson, just note down the points and wait for the discussion session. Okay, come to the reading. Before starting the reading, we are required to understand its title, which is dialogue. Dear students, dialogue is a conversation or a talk between two or more people. It means that in this lesson we are going to read out and to learn some dialogue, some conversation, or some talk between some people. Okay. In this lesson, actually, we are going to study a dialogue from two scenes. This lesson is divided into two scenes, two dialogues actually. First is between Rabia and her mother, where Rabia tells her about some cricket equipments borrowed from school and now have lost. Girls have borrowed those equipments because boys don't let them practice at school. In the next scene, the dialogue is between Rabia, their coach, and the whole class, in which Rabia tells him the issue, and their coach warns the whole class. Okay. Now, dear students, please open your English students book, page number 12. Write down date and day on the top of this page. Open your English classwork notebook and prepare your classwork page for today by writing date and day on the top of the page. Topic is dialogue, and the subtopic is not here any. Okay. Prepare your index properly. Open your English classwork notebook and the page that you have prepared for today's classwork. Add a line in the middle of the page. The left section is for words and the right one is for meanings. Dear students, when we will be reading from this lesson, I will explain you the meanings of difficult words, and you are required to write down those meanings in your this page. Okay, let's begin the reading from page number 12 from your student's book. Dear students, here where the reading of this lesson begins, the very first line is enclosed in brackets, and this phrase is Rabia's home at dinner time. What does this mean? This phrase, which is enclosed in brackets, it indicates that the dialogue we are going to reading, we are going to read, we are going to study here is in Rabia's home at dinner time. So this dialogue is between, this is the first section of this lesson, the first dialogue, which is between mother and Rabia, Rabia and her mother. The first dialogue is said by mother. Come to the reading, please. Mother: What's wrong? You have been quiet all evening. You hardly touched your dinner. Dear students, here the word mother and then colon, it indicates, it represents that the upcoming words are said by mother. Whenever we are writing any dialogue, we write, first of all, we write the name of the person which is saying those words which we are going to write. With the name, we add colon and then exactly those words which are said by the person. So this line is said by the mother, in which she asks her sister, in which she asks her daughter Rabia about her, mother noticed that Rabia is worried here. Mother noticed that Rabia hadn't touched her dinner or hadn't completed her dinner properly and seems quiet. So mother asks her the reason for why is she worried. Then back to reading. Rabia. Here Rabia, it means that the coming words are said by Rabia. Let's see what Rabia is telling her mother. Back to reading. It's nothing, mom. I have done something silly. Dear students, in this line, Rabia is trying to avoid to tell her mother that why is she worried by saying that it's nothing, I have done something silly. Okay, next, in the next line, her mother will try, or her mother will persuade her to tell the actual matter, that why is she worried. Her mother will insist her to tell. Back to reading. Mother: You seem worried. You would better tell me all about it. Rabia: Do you remember I told you about the sports coach who came to our school to teach us how to play quick cricket? Dear students, here the quick cricket means the cricket game of a few overs. Dear students, I hope you all or most of you have most of you watch the cricket game show, telecasted on television or anywhere. And if you don't watch, then at least you know that a cricket game is played in overs, and one day game is of 50 overs and T20 is of 20 overs. So here quick cricket is of a few overs, less than, it may be, I hope it will be less than 10, because the this type of cricket is played in school ground by school students in their lunch break. And the lunch break is at least the lunch break is almost of 30 minutes, and so this game should be ended in 30 minutes. So it would be of a few overs. That's why it is called quick cricket. Okay, in this line, Rabia is reminding her mother about her coach who has come to their school to teach them quick cricket. Back to reading. Mother: Yes, I do. Didn't he send you some cricket equipment so that you could practice for the junior cricket league? Rabia: Yes, he did. He told us that if we did well in the league, we could play the East Stadium during the lunch break of the next inter-school series. Okay, dear students, here Rabia and her mother are continuing their talk by mother is telling that yes, she remembers that their coach has come to their school who gave them, who provided them some equipments, cricket equipments, the tools those are used to play cricket, and is making them prepared, is helping them to practice for junior cricket league. And then Rabia tells her that yes, their coach had told them that if they play well in this junior cricket league, they will promote to the inter-school series. Back to reading. Mother: That would be wonderful. Why are you upset? Rabia: The boys never let us play, so some of us decided to borrow a bat and some wickets to practice at home. Now we have lost some of the stumps. Okay, dear students, here the actual problem is told by Rabia to her mother that the equipments which were provided by their coach were of course include some bats, some balls or wickets or stumps, etc. Now Rabia is telling that in their class boys never let them practice at school, so some of the girls decided to borrow some of the bats and some cricket other equipments to practice at home, and now some of the stumps are lost. Dear students, here borrow means to carry with oneself. What they did, they carried those equipments to home without getting permission from their coach. Here, dear students, stumps are those wooden bars which are placed on the wickets. Those wooden bars are called stumps. And now the Rabia and her friends have lost some of the stumps. Now this is the matter of matter because of the Rabia worried. Rabia is worried that first of all she has borrowed some equipments without asking their coach, and now they have lost. And when their coach will come to know about this loss, he will of course scold them, or he will maybe punish them. So Rabia is worried here. Mother, back to reading. Mother, did you ask Mr. Kashif if you could borrow the wickets? Rabia, no, we didn't. We thought he might refuse. Here, refuse means to say no to something. Mother, that was very irresponsible. You must tell him first thing in the morning and say we will replace them. Okay, dear students, now mother is telling them, telling her the solution of this problem, that first of all she says that this was very irresponsible. They have shown very irresponsible behavior towards this all issue, and now she is saying that next day when she would go to the school, she has to tell this complete issue to the coach and he will resolve it. Okay, now come to the page number 13 from your student's book. Here the next part of the dialogue starts, and before the dialogue begins, another phrase is enclosed in brackets, and the phrase is at school the next day. What does this show? Yes, it means that the dialogue which we are going to read here is at school the next day. Rabia, sir, I have something to tell you. Some of us took some cricket equipment home and now we have lost it. I am really sorry. We are going to replace it. Yes, dear students, here Rabia is telling their coach that what have done, and what do you think? What the coach will do now? He may be scold them or he may be punish them. Okay, now let's see. Back to reading. Mr. Kashif, why did you take it home? Can't you practice with it at school? Rabia, we would like to, sir, but boys never let us use it. Mr. Kashif, you should not have borrowed it without asking me. However, Rabia, it was brave of you to tell me. Yes, dear students, why Mr. Kashif says that it was brave of you to tell me? What was the matter of bravery in this whole issue? Yes, she was brave that she has told the truth in front of Mr. Kashif, that by admitting the mistake. Mr. Kashif, speaking to the whole class, listen to me carefully, please. I am feeling very disappointed. Some girls took some cricket equipments home without asking. However, they told me that the boys were not letting them use it. This is not fair. Cricket is not just about winning matches. You must all learn to be good sportsmen and sportswomen. From now on, we will have regular practice for both the girls and the boys teams. Okay, dear students, here it is the ending of our reading. in this last paragraph, Mr. Kashif is telling them that those equipments were for their whole class, for all of them, for boys and for girls. But boys didn't let them practice at home, didn't let the girls practice at school. Maybe they say that the cricket is not for them but only for boys, or maybe they say that we would not let you play at school yard, etc. So that's why girls had to borrow those equipments home. Now Mr. Kashif is resolving the issue by saying that from now on we will have regular practice for both girls and boys teams. This is the very perfect resolution of this issue, I think. You may have your different point of view here, but I think this was very perfect resolution of this issue. This was the end of our today's lesson. Now let's discuss our today's homework. Open your student's book, page number 12. It is already opened. Read the whole lesson with proper pronunciation and learn the meanings of those difficult words which I have given you. Now another homework from your workbook, page number 6. Please open your workbook, page number 6. Do exercise 1 and 2 on workbook page. Dear students, in your page number 6 from your workbook, two exercises are given. The first is read this first paragraph of the story and answer the questions. You are required to read this paragraph and answer to the questions given below. And the second exercise is use your own idea to complete the first paragraph of the story. Dear students, the first paragraph was a story that was incomplete, that was left incomplete, and now you are required to complete the story by using your own idea. I hope you all will be able to do this because it is not very difficult for you. If you find anything difficult while doing your homework, just note down the points and wait for the discussion session. This is the end of today's lesson. Good luck, students. Allah Hafiz.